positions and standing postures, and do a back position. It's a little bit more active, a little bit more physical. We're gonna go right into the sun salutations. Take just a few moments to center. If you're watching this video, the archives might pause it for a few moments. Just take a couple minutes to relax onto your back, or you can do a seated relaxation pose, just to help find your center and allow yourself to be a little bit more grounded and a little bit more present in your body. So you can move with a little bit more intentional awareness as you go through the practice. But today we'll sit up nice and tall. Taking a deep inhale together, and soften as you exhale. Inhale to grow a little bit taller, relax the shoulders, jaw, the face, and exhale all the way. Inhale, preparing for home. Flatten the palms, energize through the fingers, and hands are directly below the shoulders, and the knees directly below the hips. Now tuck the tailbone way up towards the sky. Exhale, round, come into the cat stretch, energizing through the fingers, lift the spine. Inhale, tuck the tailbone way up. Soften the face, exhale, round. Look towards the belly button. Come on, buddy. Inhale. Look up. Exhale all the way. Inhale back towards center. Pause here and take a deep breath. Hands are directly below the shoulders and knees below the hips. Tuck the toes. When you're ready, inhale, float the hips up. And the feet should be about hip distance apart. The hands are about shoulder distance apart. Bring the downward dog. Take a couple deep breaths here. Inhale, come way up onto the toes. As you exhale, bend the knees, lift the hands, move to a crouching dog. Energize through the fingers. Inhale, float forward and hover into a plank, push-up position. Exhale, down dog. Let's do that two more times. Inhale onto the toes. Exhale, bend the knees. Inhale, plank. Exhale, downward dog.
toes. Exhale, bend the knee, soften the face. Inhale, right. Exhale, now I'm going to nod. Move the hips up and pause. Let's take another deep breath. And take a deep inhale. This time as you exhale, bend the knees and the hands. And slowly lock the feet all the way forward. The feet are close to the hands. It's okay to bend the knees a little bit if it seems helpful. Relax your shoulders. It's comfortable. Release your neck. Let the weight of the head melt towards the floor. Allowing the breath to expand a little bit more. Through the shoulder blades, down into the base of the shoulder blades. Take another deep inhale. This time, as you exhale, bend the knees, squeeze the feet, and slowly roll up the spine, one vertebra at a time. Roll the heart open. Relax the shoulders. Step towards the front of the mat. Preparing for sun salutation, Surya Namaskar. Inhale, lift the toes and spread them apart. Soften the knees, root down through the feet. And then now lift up. Exhale, bring the palms together in front of the heart. Take a deep inhale. As you exhale, imagine roots growing through the bottoms of the feet, deep into the earth. Draw from those roots as you inhale, lift up. Bring that energy all the way up into the fingertips. Draw the abdominals in as you slowly dive the heart forward. Lower down. Down a little bit more. Inhale, come up halfway. Flat back. Extend through the torso. Exhale, lower down. Keeping the legs strong. Inhale, the whole body. This is up all the way. Again, nice and slow. It's okay to bend the knees, especially if you feel tightness or discomfort through the lower back, or if your hamstrings are tight. Exhale, fold forward. Lower down. Take another deep breath. And then inhale, step the right leg back. The left foot's between the hands. Energizing the fingertips. Take several deep breaths here. Hug both legs into the floor. Energize, activate through the arms. Working towards integrating into the whole body. And the right knee, hips, and shoulders, and crown of the head all into a straight line. And drawing everything in towards the midline as that line grows longer. One more deep inhale. And exhale, squeeze. Inhale, plank. Step the left leg back. And exhale, lower the knees, chest, chin, or forehead. Then as you inhale, move forward. Lift just the shoulders up off the mat, roll the shoulders back. Activate the muscle between the legs, engaging with the lumbar, and then extending up through the crown of the head, soften the face. If you'd like to, now lift the hands, strengthening, warming up the spine a little bit more as you breathe. Taking some deep abdominal breaths here, strengthening and toning the abdominals as you massage the internal organs with the breath. Face is soft. Back of the neck stays nice and long. Broadening through the shoulders. Deep inhale, come out a little more if you'd like to. And as you exhale, slide the elbows under the shoulders. Coming into the Sphinx. Continue to activate the Buddha. Gently engaging the muscle between the legs, helping to anchor the spine. Notice if you're clenching the abdominals. Sometimes if the hamstrings are tight and we start to come into a back bend, we respond by clenching those abdominal muscles to try to protect the lower back, which can be under strain from the tight hamstrings, putting pressure on the hips. So if you notice that, you might want to come back into this position when we lift up all the way to upward dog. You might want to spend more time here.
Allow those hips and lower back muscles to release. The moment you can help, drop through the shoulders and adjust to the fingers. When you're ready, lower down, slide the hands under the shoulders, tuck the toes, take another deep inhale. As you exhale, float the hips up, back into a downward dog. Pause here, take a deep breath. Once again, so it'll modify as needed as we go through this. Now step the left foot forward. It's okay to go your own pace. Exhale, the right foot steps forward, root down. Inhale, the whole body brings you back up. Nice and slow, lifting straight out, soft the shoulders, growing taller as you exhale. Staying rooted through the feet, side tuck. Inhale, lift. Exhale, lengthen as you fold. Forward and down, nice and slow. Now come up halfway, flat back. Exhale, lower. Inhale, the whole body brings you back up. Again, modify as needed. Lengthen. And forward, nice and slow. Control your movement. Pause here, take another deep breath. Step the left leg back. Lunge step two. Right foot's between my hands. Knees directly above the heel. Square the hips and the shoulders. Extend the crown. Soften the face, eyes. Again, working towards integrating the whole body. Without over-activating in any particular area. Working towards engaging evenly through the fingers, the legs, core muscles, strong for the core of the body. Keeping one breath full. Let's take one more deep inhale. Gently squeeze, exhale. And soften. Inhale, step the right leg back. As you exhale, lower the knees. Chest, chin, or forehead, make some snow. And again, you might come back around the forearms, and the sphinx, like the last time, or forward, and lift all the way into up dog, grabbing the shoulders within the back of the neck long, hugging the elbows in towards the sides of the ribcage, now open the chest. And again, notice it feels like the hips are spring-loaded, and you want to shoot back towards the ceiling. You might come back onto the forearms and allow more time for the lower back and hips to relax. Otherwise, energize down through the toes, keeping the chest open. Notice if the shoulders are shrugging and you're lifting up towards the ears, or to keep the chest broad, the neck long. One more deep inhale. Exhale, downward dog. Take a deep breath here. Now step right foot forward. Exhale, left foot go down. Now the whole body lifts back up. Exhale, palms together. Take a deep cleansing breath. Exhale, flowing right through, downward dog. Inhale, left foot forward.
Exhale, fold. Inhale, flat back, halfway up. Exhale, lower, move down. Inhale, come up all the way, look up. Lengthen as you fold. Still moving with the breath. So now left leg back. Exhale, gently squeeze. Inhale, right leg back. Exhale, lower down. Inhale, up and down. Exhale, down, down. Inhale, right foot forward. Exhale, left foot forward. Inhale, up. Palms together. Take a deep breath. Step the right leg back. Line the left heel up with the arch of the right foot. Right toes turning a little bit. Left toes point directly towards the front. Inhale, arms out wide so they're directly above the legs. Spiral the hips open as that left knee lunges towards the second lower toe. Shoulders right above the hips. Broadening through the chest as you energize out the fingertips. Grounding through both legs, feet. The arch is lifted. Breathe, expanding, Virabhadrasana to warrior two pose. Face soft as you look over the extended left arm. You might imagine standing next to the wall, flat against that imaginary wall. Exhale, look down the left foot. Press
stand on both legs.
Now to come up, bigger. Relax arms down. Scoot the right foot in just a little bit. Make sure the left toes didn't turn in. Hug the left hip back. Inhale, the right arm lifts up. Still grounding through the feet. Draw the abdominals in. Grow longer as you extend over the left leg. And then lower the left, or the right hand towards the left thigh, the shin, maybe all the way down to the floor. Hug the left hip back and lift the left arm up towards the sky. Keep the right heel planted on the mat. Keep the breath full. Take another deep inhale. And as you exhale, lower the left arm down. Take a deep breath. When you're ready, move down to the feet. Inhale to circle the right arm up. Open the arms out wide. Let the right foot swing back. Exhale. Take another deep inhale. And as you exhale, lunge. Lower the left thigh, or the left forearm to the thigh. Make sure the left knee is again going towards that second little toe. Toes pointing directly towards the front. And then bring the right arm into a straight line with the right leg. Here, still engaging with the Buddha, kind of drawing the abdominals in and lengthening through the whole right side of the body. Exhaling all the way. When you're ready, inhale to circle the right arm back, all the way around. Tuck the left hip back, and then again, you might keep the right hip planted. The heel wants to lift up, and it's hard to keep it planted. And allow the heel to lift up and the foot to turn all the way, and that will allow you to get a little bit more out of it. It's good to commit one way or the other. Extend the left arm to the back, grounding through that back heel, or allowing it to lift, lengthening from the left fingers to the right heel. Now the circle of the left arm back, all the way around, take a deep breath. And then inhale to step the left leg back. Exhale, lower down, knees, chest, chin, or forehead, left elbow goes in. Inhale, lower dog. Exhale, downward dog. Take a deep inhale. Step the right foot forward, switch to the other side. When you're ready, inhale, come up. Nice wide stance. Ground through the feet. Inhale, upper arms out wide. Spiral hips open. The right knee comes forward towards the second little toe. Arms parallel with the floor. Shoulders right above the hips. Integrating, activating the muscle between the legs. Drawing the abdominals in, helping to stabilize the core. The face is solid. Another deep inhale. If you'd like to lunge a little bit more as you exhale. And now open, energize out with your fingertips. When you're ready, release the arms down. Bring the left hand to the thigh, and now the right arm up towards the sky. Make a crescent shape. The back side of the body still strong. Both legs, grounding through the feet, arches are lifting. Triangle pose. Extend over that front leg, grounding through the feet, again
right to another gut, pull that thumb, exhale it down to the right foot, press down the legs, and then come up and get bigger. Relax, arms down, scoop the left foot in a little bit, look the right back. Now the left arm is up, Arvita Trikonasana. Keep the left heel planted in this one. Lower down as much as it feels comfortable. Tuck the right hip back. And if you'd like to lift the right arm up towards the sky, breathe here.
The house isn't quite big enough to breathing video to learn those exercises and incorporate them into a daily practice. Pranayama, the word prana refers to the life force energy, and the word yama means to control or to restrain. And doing those breathing exercises really helps us to cultivate and harness that life force energy. And that's another thing you can do with your social distancing and your pranayama practices while you're going to the store. You can regulate your own breathing. Take deep breaths while you're in a big open space. Not breathe as much while you're maybe a little bit closer to people. That's a way that you can help to regulate your own prana through being conscious of when you take deep breaths, when you're maybe a little closer to people than you might feel comfortable. That's just one way that the breathing exercise can help. Thank you for sharing your practice. May you be blessed with radiant health and